All right, we are moving on to the right side of the bracket. First up, we have Princess Elise versus White Michael Jackson here on Duck Hunt. And all right, let's see what we got going on. Up smash immediately from Michael Jackson. Pretty much even right now. Just kind of rolls into that forward smash. Really don't want to be doing that, to be honest. And well, Princess Elise actually looking competent for probably the first time ever. Michael Jackson just, I don't really know what he's doing right now. He's kind of just, okay, you know what, that was a nice up tilt. Okay, nice back throw. Is Princess Elise even gonna kind of do some weird stuff to, oh, you know what? Okay, what are you doing? Okay. I think Princess Elise went in for a footstool disrespect on White Michael Jackson. White Michael Jackson, not a good showing right there. He just, okay, you know, he's just lying. I don't even really know what happened. He kind of went for the edge guard, got hit by, I think, Princess Elise's up-B, and then just kind of didn't come back. Yeah, Princess Elise looking very solid right now. Michael Jackson, what are you gonna do? You can't be beaten by her. Like she's basically the worst video game character ever. Like, you lose to Princess Elise, like, that's just sad. You know what I'm saying? Anyways, Michael Jackson probably gonna lose to Princess Elise, given the fact that he's already a full stock behind, and really just not playing too well in general. Anyway, Princess Elise, alright, let's, nice down air. Michael Jackson, okay, does a air dodge to get back. For some reason, decides to counter, like, literally nothing, and, yeah, he's gonna get punished for that big. That's a, okay, down smash didn't kill, whatever that next move is also didn't kill, but White Michael Jackson, already at 143, 4 tilt not gonna kill just yet. Okay, yeah, Magna Hands are a thing, but up smash, finally gonna take Princess Elise's first stock. White Michael Jackson, already at 143, like, yeah. This is not looking good, to be honest, for White Michael Jackson. He's like, yeah, he's already at 178. He has not died yet. Technically, they are still at, both at two stocks, so this is kind of even. I mean, not really, obviously, but, like, I always like to think that, like, if you're at even stocks, there's, like, a lot more hope than, like, if Michael Jackson is, well, now he's lost a stock, and now I consider him to be very far behind, but that's just kind of my mentality. All right, Michael Jackson, what are you going to do there? You don't want to kill yourself. That's kind of the main thing, is it's like, a lot of these Miis like to go off stage and then just kind of almost die, so we don't want to do it. Michael Jackson, okay, he did have his second jump, so there's that at least, but okay, yeah, this is not looking good for him, like I've been saying a lot, and let's see. He is just throwing those missiles, and okay, forward smash went to do something, and okay, I feel like he charged that for way too long. Like, he could have snuck that in there somewhere. I don't actually even know what move that was. I think that was side B, which is basically like Ike side B. And yeah, that's what that move was. And alright, Michael Jackson kind of doing things. Not really a lot, but he's okay, and that up smash is not going to kill just yet, but another one definitely will. Michael Jackson basically on his last leg. This is like do or die. Like, you gotta take this stock, which I think he actually just did. Okay, don't go for any disrespect. Now you have to. Now he's gotta play well. He is definitely at kill percent, and Princess Elise definitely doesn't want to throw this huge lead away, as you know we haven't technically seen yet, but has been the case a lot. Like, I feel like that's always the case. Maybe like when you have like level 9 versus level 9, they try and like keep it even, except for the games which weren't even close to even, so I don't really know. But anyways, Michael Jackson currently at 165. I'm pretty sure any missile will kill, so isn't, okay, I think that was the weak missile, because like that's sort of like Samus missile, where you have the weak missile and the strong missile. So and oh my god, I think got the down B, or I mean I think I got the up B spike. Princess Elise just bodied Michael Jackson. Wow, that's something. Alright, next up we've got Big Chungus versus Grunkle Stan here on, I think this is Yoshi's Island Brawl. Is that what the name of the stage? I can never remember, like, which of these stages is Yoshi's Island Brawl, and which of these stages is, Yoshi's Story Melee. I think this is Yoshi's Island Brawl. Yeah, anyways, let's see. Both competitors just, once again, really like to stay off the edge, and, yeah, Grunkle Stan just kind of dead, because he went off stage too far, and then just kind of got hit once. Like, that's the thing, is it's like, they use, like, they like jump off the stage, then use their double jump to get back, and that's the point where like if the opponent just kind of hits them, then like they're just kind of like, he's dead again. Like, what are you doing? Stop going off stage. You're just gonna die. Like, you're gonna get three stocked. Okay, well that was an interesting, like, okay, Grunkle's dead, at least, I guess he's like, you know what, if I'm gonna get completely bide, I may as well at least get some, go for some style points. At least he got that down there, which is something. And, I guess, maybe he can pull this back. I actually don't know how good Big Chungus is. I mean, granted, Big Chungus is probably the first CPU we've really seen take really good advantage of, like, doing some really good edge guarding, I guess, taking advantage of these core Meat Fighter recoveries. So, I guess he's got that going for him. Right now, he's kind of getting bodied. Uncle Stan, I guess, decided he wanted to win after all. He's not going off stage anymore. Okay, he just went off stage for, like, no reason. But, like, yeah, he's done a lot of damage, and, okay, I thought he just kind of killed himself again, but he did not, so that's good. Just kind of throwing these shot puts, that's pretty good damage. Nice up smash! Wow, Grunkle Stan really brought this back. He went from basically two stocks down to only 76% down, which, like, is still a lot, and is currently dead, but there was effort, like, eventually. Just kind of, if he hadn't killed himself twice, like, in the first 30 seconds, that game might have gone differently, but he did, so this is what happened. Alright, we've got Steve Harvey versus Groose here on Dreamland, a stage that used to be legal but now isn't, which is fine because wind is lame. Wind isn't even on because I believe that's considered a hazard, but whatever. Alright, we got a Sword Fighter Ditto. Both people seem to really love up smashing, which makes sense. Up smash is pretty good. You got the three hits, so you can't parry it. I mean, I guess you could do a triple parry, and okay, Steve Harvey has that recovery. Let's, oh, that was a nice one. That was like, I think, forward air to down smash, and okay, nice parry from Groose. I feel like he just could have just jumped over that, and that might have been better, but okay, wow, how did that attack even hit? Like, he got like the, like, disjoint hitbox of that move, and other than that, he might have actually died. Okay, let's see. Basically even right now. If you're wondering, the down B Groose has is basically like Ganondorf down B. So it's like you can do it either on the ground where it goes horizontally or like in the air where it goes like down at the angle. And okay, Groose, interesting attempt at a punish. And nice moves. Okay, Steve Harvey should be able to make this back. And okay, nice nair! Amazing edge guard, Groose! I feel like he was started to go for disrespect and then was like, you know what? I'm probably gonna die if I do that. I'm not gonna do that. So smart move for him. Now he's just kind of, I don't really know what they're doing right now. I think Groose may be going for a timeout or something. That seems to be his, he was just kind of like running away for a little while. Okay, now he's come to life. Steve Harvey, gonna have to do something. Groose just kind of, Groose doing a great job of nairing, like, both Steve Harvey out of both his up. Oh, that's unfortunate. That's an early kill on Steve Harvey. Yeah, Groose doing a great job of nairing out of both Steve Harvey's up B and his side B, so yeah, Groose still on his first stock. Wow, this is looking grim for Steve Harvey. Steve Harvey has to do something. Like, Groose just all over him right now. Great little bit of swords play right there. I mean, okay, Groose looking like he almost just died right there. I mean, to be fair, Groose is like the greatest hero greatest champion Hyrule has ever seen, so this might have been a bit of an unfair matchup to begin with. Like, I mean, you really just can't beat Groose. He's basically unbeatable. So the fact that Steve Harvey's getting thoroughly destroyed is really not, I guess, is somewhat to be expected. Anyways, Groose still living at 152. Steve Harvey on his last stock, and he's dead. Like, what do you expect when you fight Groose? Groose is too good, and maybe that's not, I think that's why he's not in Smash. It's because, like, he just beat everyone, so. But here he is now, and very good three stock. Great showing from Groose. Excited to see him later on. Alright, and we've got Paul Blart versus Rick Sanchez, aka Thick Rick, the ultimate form of Rick. And okay, both people clearly had the exact same idea, which is just charge shot, and then just kind of shoot it. Well, I think, okay, well, there's Rick. Rick shot his at that point, and just kind of shot it again. Yeah, I guess we have a Mii Gunner Ditto. These people, I'm not sure if they have the same moveset or not. Both people definitely have a charge shot, which is probably Mii Gunner's best neutral B move, because it's basically like Samus' charge shot, except I think a little faster even, so yeah, that's good, and, you know, definitely a kill option. Alright, both people playing off stage right now, which may lead to some... Okay, I think that's it for Paul Blart. Yeah, okay, you know what, Rick, I guess, decided Paul Blart was not done, but could not disrespect him any more than that, missed his second attempt at disrespecting. Alright, Paul Blart came back fuming that he got disrespected immediately. Okay, immediately, a lot of good conversions right there. Rick, I think you might have made a mistake. You don't want to mess with Paul Blart, honestly. But then again, Rick just kind of does whatever he wants and does it very well. Anyways, all right. Rick, basically, looking at kill percent right now, he is a thick boy, so maybe not just yet. Okay, wow. Paul Blart does the exact same thing Rick did to him, which is just nair him out of his recovery. I think both the recoveries they have is the one that doesn't actually have a hitbox on it, so you can just kind of knock them out of it, and yeah, it's not the best of recoveries. It's pretty good distance-wise, but like, yeah, if you just kind of get hit, it's just kind of all over for you. If you get hit away from the stage, which is what happened to both Rick and Paul Blart. All right, let's see what we got going on. Rick still currently in the lead. I guess it's not really that close, but Paul Blart could definitely still bring this back. He just kind of has to, you know, start actually doing damage. Okay, that was a nice up tilt, nice down air. Rick just kind of randomly lets that charge shot go. Not really sure why. And all right, nice forward smash from Paul Blart, really bringing this one back. I think Rick is okay. Nice forward. Okay, that did barely kill. And I think Rick, he's probably going for a little bit. He's going for like those 200 IQ plays, I'd imagine. But maybe he's just going a little bit too far. Okay, wow, that was a nice back air from Paul Blart. Not gonna kill just yet. And if he did it facing the other direction, it definitely nice charge shot just clips him. And okay, we have an even game right here. Rick versus Paul Blart and charging those charge shots. Nice reflector, Rick. Able to shield just in time. I don't know if Rick had a reflector too. That would have been cool if they did like a double reflector. And okay, both people. This is where danger is when you. Okay, I guess Paul Blart was able to get his forward smash out first. I think they both tried to forward smash each other, and Paul Blart is the one that came out. All right, Paul Blart, in the lead for I think the first time this entire game. Rick probably wants to use nice forward air right there right now. Okay. Goes for the down air. Probably wanted to nair instead. That would have been a safer option. But, alright. Paul Blart maybe wants a little bit of disrespect or something like that. Alright, nice. Just kind of up smashes him out of whatever move he was trying to do. So, okay. And Paul Blart really just bringing this away. Okay. Nice parries and then is still able to roll. Nice charge shot right there. But that was really nice from Rick when he parried and then was able to roll out of the other hits of up smash right there. Okay. Nice parry into. Okay, up smash still not gonna kill just yet, but all right, both people hit. Oh my God, Paul Blart shoots his charge shot into nice charge shot again, and okay, that is gonna kill. I was gonna say, Paul Blart shot his charge shot straight into Rick's to avoid it. Just kind of charges up charge shot again, and then just lets it loose immediately and kills Rick. Wow, Paul Blart. Yeah, you do not want to count Paul Blart out. He will find a way, even if it does not seem likely. Alright, we've got Green Arrow versus Robbie Rotten here on Halbro. This should be a fun time. We got the greatest hero versus the greatest villain, or the number one villain. And, alright, let's see. Arrow, you know, I think Robbie Rotten failed your city. You're going to have to do something about that. He's trying to make people lazy. Not good. And, okay, wow, Arrow just kind of all over him right now. Robbie Rotten is kind of getting bodied, but you know, it's early. Things can happen. Things can definitely change. And, alright, nice dash attack. Okay, Arrow just kind of... Oh, nice! Okay, Arrow is able to get back, though. That's kind of like always like a... It's kind of like a lucky guess if you, like, when you, like, recover through the middle, if you can, like, get yourself all the way through and then recover. Because if you don't get all the way through, you just die. And, okay, for some reason, Arrow really wants to go off stage. I mean, he definitely has a better neutral. He's playing very well when he is center stage, but, went off stage, and yeah, that kind of killed him because Robbie Rotten took the first stock. And alright, Arrow looking for a way back in this. He still definitely can make it through. Robbie Rotten currently at 152%, and alright, back air is going to take that. So, yeah. Alright, Robbie Rotten, forward smash is just kind of Oh, you hate to see that happen. That is why Halbert is not a fun stage to play on, because sometimes you just kind of die. Like, because there are ledges, but like, sometimes you miss the ledge and instead you start to go through and then just kind of down. And honestly, might be better if like you couldn't pass through the bottom, because then you might like kind of like go across the top to like the ledge. But the fact that you can go through the bottom means that you basically will only be able to go towards the ledge if you're like go like straight there. Anyways, Robbie Ron just kind of sneaking these stocks away. Like, Air is definitely playing better in the neutral, but I mean, Robbie Ron is winning. He's getting the edge guards and taking advantage of the stage. So, yeah, and okay, now he's playing well. Now, okay, that's definitely gonna kill, yeah. Onslaught kills it. Probably around 100 with no rage, and even earlier if you do have rage. So, pretty good move. Probably one of me Brawler's best moves, in my opinion. Okay. I don't really know why Arrow just kind of jumped into that forward smash. He really shouldn't have. And, alright, Robbie Rotten, he has a plan right now, and he is making this work. Alright, Onslaught right there. Arrow definitely at kill percent. Onslaughts again, making those Onslaughts work. Personally, I wouldn't do Onslaught until, like, I don't really like to do Onslaught, like, at early percents, because I think it's a very... Oh my god, he almost got the, like... backflip spike. I think that move does spike, just like Zero Suit Samus's if you get over the stage. Okay, wow. That forward smash is so big. Barely clips Arrow when he tried to run. And Robbie Rotten is victorious. Number one villain, proving to be the number one Mii fighter as well, maybe. We'll have to see what happens going forward, won't we? Oh, wow. And we have got a fight next. We have Ultra Instinct Shaggy versus Super Saiyan God Velma. Personally, I really wish maybe I'd set it up so that, like, these two people were on, like, opposite sides of the bracket. Because, like, this isn't a match you want to see first round. This is, like, what you want the grand finals to be. But, unfortunately, when you randomize the bracket, that's what we got. So that's what we're going to see. We're going to see probably the two most formidable fighters in the tournament take on each other at round one, which maybe is a good thing, because at least we get to see them fight. I mean, you know, things can happen. Maybe one of them could have gotten eliminated early. So at least we're getting the battle of the century right here. All right, let's see. Velma starting off strong. Shaggy gets two backflips in. All right, nice parry down smash into her own down smash. And okay, but you know, definitely can never count out Shaggy. Like, he's just obviously with his Ultra Instinct, he's like. Technically, he's probably the stronger being right here, but, you know, he just has to summon it, which can only happen if someone says the word bad, and I'm not sure if Velma did that before the game started, so we'll have to see what happens. All right, Ultra Instinct Shaggy. Nice Onslaught. I honestly thought that might have killed with all that rage. Both characters do have Onslaught, and both of them will definitely kill now, as demonstrated by Velma right there. Brutal. Shaggy is the one who loses his first stock, but he can definitely bring this back. Not too far behind, and okay, Velma going for a very, very early kill, maybe just one of the damage, but okay, nice, here's Helicopter Kick, there's not nearly as good as it was in the last game, but still, in my opinion, Mii Brawler's best recovery move, and you do have some combos, I'm pretty sure that, because Mii Brawler's the only one of the Miis I kind of play, I actually play the Velma one, that's like the main one I play, and I know that a down throw into Helicopter Kick is true at percents up to like maybe 40-ish or so. So that's why I think Mii Brawler is kind of underrated. Not necessarily good, but just underrated. And one of the characters I like to play. Not my main, but just a character I like to play. Anyways, Velma really doing pretty good right now. I don't think Shaggy has really gotten a lot of hits on her this whole stock. I think she was at like 120 when he died, and now she's only at one. Okay, dash attack is going to kill. Yeah, dash attack is a kill move for Mii Brawler, as you can see. But, so Shaggy finally takes that first stock, but currently at 120. Nice use of the shot put. Yeah, the shot put is a really good move. Probably Mii Brawler's best neutral B. It's very good at edge guarding. Like, you can edge guard, like, any character, like a character like Crom. If you, like, stand in the right place and just throw shot puts, Crom can never recover. Because, for one thing, you don't even have to time it that well. Because, like, you can have it land on the stage and then just kind of, like, stay towards the edge and it'll just hit at some point. So, it's actually a very good and underrated projectile. Anyways, Shaggy trying to bring this back. Nice one hit of Nair, just nice Nair in general. And Shaggy is, Shaggy, that might have worked if you were a stock ahead, but I think Velma kind of missed a tech right there. Maybe that was untechable, but Shaggy is a little bit too low. Can now recover, and Shaggy actually out in round one. Wow, to be fair, he did lose to Super Saiyan God Velma, who is arguably an even stronger warrior, and definitely like they were definitely the two strongest warriors going into this, so honestly whatever happened. Speaking of strongest warriors in the universe, next up we have Android 17, the MVP of the Tournament of Power, versus Jake Paul, or actually that's Logan Paul, the MVP of being bad YouTubers, I guess. And alright, let's see. Logan Paul starting off strong. I guess he has a good he has a fighter too. He did beat KSI or something like that. Cause you have no idea who won. I don't watch stuff like that. But okay, he is proving to be somewhat competent. And alright, Android 17, maybe going a little easy on him, given the fact that it is Logan Paul. Don't want to try too hard against a mere mortal. And okay, yeah, Logan Paul just kind of killed himself for some reason. Maybe wants to show himself on his next video or something like that. Alright, anyways, wow! Android 17 spot dodged through like 10 different attacks and then up smash. Yeah, I think Android 17 just kind of toying with Logan Paul at this point. Like, he knows that Logan Paul's no match for him, so he's just... Look at Paul, like, I honestly thought he just killed himself again. This is another stage that, like, just like Hallbird, okay, Logan Paul's dead again. But, like, once again, basically the entire bottom you can go through, but and there are, like, grabbable edges, but it's like if you miss the edge, and, okay, there's the Logan Paul dropkick that we all know and love. Only a full stock behind, and, okay, Android 17, I thought was gonna homie stock him, but, did not actually want to do that. Okay, wow, that's, interesting, the last hit of Onslaught didn't actually come off. That's actually a thing on certain like moving platforms, including Lylat. Like, Onslaught doesn't always work on the slanted parts of Lylat, which makes me very sad, but whatever, Lylat's lame anyways. Lylat is actually not included in the stages. I took it out because no one likes that stage. Anyways, okay, Android 17 does make it back. I didn't know if he was going to make it through the stage or not, but is able to make it through. Alright, let's see what we got. Alright, nice. Okay, Android 17 wants to end this in style. Logan Paul maybe has a little bit more fight in him, probably trying to make up for the fact that he SD'd twice very early. And okay, Onslaught, that honestly probably would have killed, well, if you keep on doing it, it's just gonna stale, and then it's not gonna, okay, and 17 not able to make it back there. That might have kind of missed the ledge and then kind of passed through the stage. Also, since this is, okay, and Android 17 is like, you know what, I've had enough of this guy, I'm just gonna forward smash him and kill him. But like, if you have hazard screen off, like the barrel at the bomb does not appear, so if you miss the stage, you're just kind of dead. Anyway, Android 17, easy win against Logan Paul. I don't really think anyone expected this to go any other way, so, eh, whatever. Alright, and time for the final battle of round one. It is original Michael Jackson versus White Canary. Another two sets of brawlers. I think probably most of the Miis are brawlers, because that's the one I play the most, as I said. Anyways, we are on, I believe this is, okay, White Canary is dead. I don't really know how that happened, but, yeah, that happened. I actually have no idea if this is Town and City or Smashville. I can't really tell when it's hazards off. And, okay, Michael Jackson is dead also. I don't really know what these CPUs are doing. It seems to be the Mii Brawlers more than any of the others, is they just jump off the stage, recover in the wrong direction, and then just die. And, like, I feel like it's happened a lot. Anyways, well, I guess if both characters do an equal amount of times, it's still even, isn't it? Anyways, pretty much even game right now. White Canary a little bit in the lead, but not... Okay, and the Michael Jackson dropkick coming into play, going to even it out a bit. Okay, Michael Jackson really wants to get the counter throw. Did it four times in a row for some reason. I honestly thought White Canary was gonna die right there. Like, I really didn't think she was making it back, but she did. Okay, okay, both people are back. Just people, like, the CPUs are so unpredictable. I don't even really know what's going to happen half the time. They're always off the stage. They're doing weird moves. They're like recovering in the wrong direction. And all right, let's see. Nice down air. Okay, nice throw. Actually, does do a little bit of humbling. Fourth throw is a kill throw, as I said. Gonna need it to be a little bit more percent. Nice back air from White Canary. Gonna take Michael Jackson's second stock. White Canary looking pretty good right now. Does have a kind of decent amount of percent, but like, I have no idea what percent Michael Jackson's gonna decide is kill percent. Alright, does 31%. Very well played. Let's see what we got. Okay, nice forward tilt is not going to recover. White Canary has helicopter kick. Michael Jackson, I really just kind of thought was dead at that point, but I guess he's not done just yet. White Canary, alright, now, okay, nice forward smash. Well, if White Canary did any sort of move, Michael Jackson probably would have died, but just kind of jumped off and then jumped back. Anyway, so as you can see, Michael Jackson finally was able to kill White Canary, and now we are at one stock apiece. I'd like to say that Michael Jackson is not looking good, but the fact is just that White Canary could just kind of SD at any point, so I don't really want to say if anyone is really in the lead. Or Michael Jackson could do a great conversion, and then I honestly thought he was dead. White Canary almost died there too. I feel like White Canary just kind of... Okay, nice counter throw. Not going to kill just yet, but maybe a little... Maybe like one more time that might actually do it, especially if it's a strong attack. White Canary goes for the craziest down air. Not going to get it. Why are these characters... Like, these... Think about the Miis. They play so unsafe. And okay, dash attack is going to kill. That was... Dash attack very close to the edge. He's able to kill off the side. But like, the Miis play so unsafe that it's like... You never know when the game is going to be over, even when they're at such high percent. Anyways, White Canary going to win that one. And that is the end of round one. We are, next up, we move on to the round of 16.